We have confetti and fireworks going off because today, Sunday, June 6, 2021, is a celebration Sunday. We are celebrating my 20th year here at Holley, and I'm looking forward to many more. We're celebrating Gene Reynolds' 80th year as a part of this church family. This is the only church he's ever been a part of. We are also celebrating the 150th anniversary of this church being dedicated to helping build Christ's kingdom here on earth. And I'm so glad that you're a part of today's celebration, whether you're here on Sunday or later in the week. And if you let me know you're here, I would really appreciate that. I'd be honored by that. The best way for you to let me know you're here is to fill out your connection card at Holley Church Online. If you're already at Holley Church Online, you're all set. Just click on that connection card tab. It opens up a brand new page. If you're on one of our social media sites, you can leave that site up, open up a new page. Go to holleychurch.org, click Online Church, take you right to that connection card tab. And if you're new here at Holley Church, I'd love to send you a gift as our way of saying thanks for being here. It's a book co-written by myself called Unshakable, and all you need to do to receive your free gift is fill out your connection card at Holley Church Online and just mark that box that says, I'm watching for the first or second time. The worship team is going to lead us in some celebration, and I'll be back right after that.
Bring all your failures, bring your addictions, come let
All throughout the Bible, milestones are celebrated. And that's what we're doing as a church family today. We are celebrating. We're celebrating Jean Reynolds being a part of this church family for 80 years. She was brought here as a baby, and this is the only church she's ever attended. And that's really amazing.
I was so young, I don't remember exactly when my mother brought us. And I even came all through high school because my dad had a rule. If you didn't go to church on Sunday, you couldn't go out on Friday, Saturday night. So we always came to church on Sunday all through, and I just never quit. I wouldn't want to go anywhere else. I love this church. It's my home. Yeah. Well, this is totally different. There used to be a wood stove right here, and the walls were right through there. There was no stage, wood floor, chairs you moved around. So, yeah, it was a lot different. Oh, that's hard. I just love everything about this church. So just have one favorite memory? I don't think so. Okay. Kevin?
Are you trying to slip for money on the side over here?
Kevin definitely has been my favorite pastor. I've liked some others. I like Bob Church. But, yeah.
Thank you, Jean. Jean has been a very important part of my life, my family's life. Jean was the first person from Holley that we met in person, and she has been a constant source of love and support and strength over these years. And what a milestone, 80 years as a part of this church family. Show Jean some love. We're also celebrating this local church, this part of Christ's kingdom, being here for 150 years. This is Holley Church's 150th anniversary. 150 years of being a light for the truth and the hope and the love of Jesus, not only in the community of Holley, but in the surrounding communities as well and out into the world. We are so thrilled to be, and we're going to continue to be, a vital and vibrant part of this community. Would you please join me in a prayer of celebration? Jesus, thank you for establishing your church here in Holley. You've blessed us, Jesus, and we thank you for that. Thank you for guiding it and protecting it and empowering it over the years. We are humbled in your presence and ask for a double outpouring of your Spirit upon this church family. Help us build and strengthen your kingdom here on earth. And we feel your presence and we rest in the hope and assurance that you are always with us. May your kingdom come and your will be done here on earth. And we give you the glory, the honor, and the dominion forever and ever. Amen. I have been blessed to serve with Holley Church for 20 of those 150 years that this church has been in existence. And when my family and I arrived here in 2001, it wasn't exactly on my radar to still be here in 2021. But God obviously had different plans. And I believe I am exactly where God wants me to be. Now, the fact that it was not on my radar to be here at Holley 20 years later didn't have anything to do with the church, but had everything to do with where I believed God was leading me. And I didn't think where God was leading me could happen here at Holley. But God's an expert on taking what we believe can't happen, you know, making the impossible possible. And this is a very personal message for me today. It's very personal to this church. I've done quite a lot of different things over the years. I've had and many different types of jobs. God has designed me in such a way that I'm able to do a lot of different things, but he called me to be a pastor. What's a call from God? Does he pick up the God phone and dial your phone number? Sort of. Now, there are at least two different types of calls from God. There are general calls from God. For instance, God calls the whole world, for God so loved the world that he sent his only son. So God calls the whole world to be restored to him through believing in his son, Jesus Christ, and in believing in Jesus' death, burial, and resurrection to life. God calls every believer in Jesus to be baptized into Jesus, to be immersed into Jesus. Another general call God gives to every Christian is the call to serve, to make a difference with their lives by serving. So there are general calls from God, and then there are specific calls from God. God picks up the God phone, and he actually dials your number. He calls you to do something specific. It may be he wants you to serve. He wants you to help out in a specific way in his kingdom. Or he may be calling you specifically to give financially to a part of his kingdom work. Now, this isn't the regular tithes or offerings. This is a specific gift to be specifically used in part of God's work that he's calling you to give. So there are general calls on every Christian's life, and there are specific calls from God. And I sensed a specific call from God to be a pastor very clearly when it wasn't on the radar of my life at all. And I obeyed, and he opened up the doors for me to be working with different churches from that moment on, confirming my calling at that time. But then this crisis happened in my life, and it shattered my faith. And I stepped away from being a pastor, and I stepped away from involvement in Jesus' church. And this is going to sound strange, but now looking back on it, it was all God's doing. It was all his call on my life. Because even as I was moving away from God, I was moving toward another arena in my life that God had called me to do. And that was to start my own business, which I did. And even though during this time period, I had about a zero relationship with God on my part, you know, I even questioned his realness at times, but he is real. And he was working his calling in my life throughout that whole season where I didn't realize it at the time, but looking back, I do. He was taking me through experience after experience to prepare me for my work here, my ministry here. Now, I eventually sold that business, and then I did some work for the government for a short while. I also worked with a financial planner. I set up and ran an eBay business for the owner of a pawn shop, and then eventually for myself. I did some in-home care. I started a home church meeting in my house. And you say, well, wait a minute, where did that come from, Kevin? I thought you were kind of distancing yourself from God. I thought you weren't walking with him. Well, that's right. I wasn't at first, but over the years, God brought people into my life. And through those people, God helped restore my relationship with him. Now, all that time was a strange, turbulent period. But during this season of disconnect from God on my part, not on his part, but on my part, God was actually forming within me the vision he had for the church I was going to be leading. He was preparing me for coming to Holley. Now, before that could happen, though, God had to reconfirm his calling on my life to be a pastor. And I remember the day quite vividly. I was driving down Main Street in Emmett, Idaho, and I was driving past the sawmill that they shut down on the day we moved here. And all of a sudden, out of nowhere, tears began streaming down my face. And I was like, what is this? And God spoke very clearly to my heart and said, I want you back. I want you back as a shepherd of my church. And then I understood what those tears were all about, because I didn't think he'd ever want me back. I didn't think anyone would want me back. I didn't think any church would want me. It'd been around 10 years or so since I'd worked with a church, so I wasn't sure how all this was going to play out, how all this was going to happen. I just knew God was telling me, Kevin, you have a new season ahead of you being a pastor of my church. Now, at this point, I had no idea where he wanted me to go or to be, but I sensed strongly that he wanted me to go to a place that needed a church and begin one. My longtime friend, Bob Wood, was at that time, and still is, the director of a church planting organization here in the state of Oregon. So when the church at Holley said, hey, we want you to come and be our pastor, I thought, okay, God, you're bringing all the pieces into place for me to get settled into Oregon. And then after 3 to 3.5 years of gaining experience as a senior pastor of Holley Christian Church, because I'd never been the lead pastor before. I'd always been an associate pastor. I'd always been on staff at churches. So I felt I needed some experience as a lead pastor in an existing church before God would send me to where a new church needed to be started in Oregon. And I felt, hey, 3 to 3.5 years, that's a good time frame to gain experience, but I must be a really slow learner because it's 20 years later and I'm still here. Why? Well, what happened? Well, God did want me to help bring about a new beginning here in Oregon. I just didn't realize at first it was right here in Holley where he wanted me to help bring about that new beginning. Honestly, when I arrived here in 2001, I said to myself, I'm not changing anything at this church. I just want to get some experience and then start a new church in a community in Oregon that really needs it. Now, God had given me and has given me a very clear vision for the type of church he wants me to lead. A church that does not primarily focus on themselves, but is focused outward on making an impact for good in their community, and a church where broken and disillusioned and hurt and sinful people and happy people, all types of people, can come together and learn how their lives can be continually changed and restored by Jesus. A church that doesn't only send money overseas and then neglects their own community, but a church that focuses first and foremost on the community around them. A church that really cares about each other, and a church that would be missed if it were gone, not just by the people who attend, but by the community around it. Now, I've made a lot of mistakes. I still do. But God has brought and is bringing the vision he gave me into existence right here. And leading this church is where God wants me to be. I've never veered from leading this church away from the vision that God gave me for it. And I've had people get upset with me. I know that's hard to imagine, right? But I have had people get upset with me, but I've refused and I will refuse to veer from the vision God has given me for this church. And God has been achieving the impossible through us, because I couldn't do it without you, for several years. Now, this church has grown numerically since 2001, but for me, it never has been and never will be just about numbers of people attending a worship service. It's about people and expanding our influence as a church. And I want us to continue to look forward to achieving the impossible. And again, I could never achieve the impossible without you. So thank you. And I'm looking forward to many more years of Jesus working through us. Here's a video of some highlights from the first 20 years. been a great time of celebration today. Thanks for being a vital part of Holley Church. Check out today's next steps on your connection card, which again, you'll find at Holley Church online. And I want to mention one of those next steps. It says, I'll invite. And there's a blank line there for you. You can put a first name in there. You can put initials in there to church. And I'm asking you to do this because we're starting a brand new message series next week called Why. Why do bad things happen? Why did God allow this to happen to me or to someone I love? Why? It's a tough and it's a very common question that people have about God. And it gives you an opportunity to invite someone to church, whether it's online or in person. Faithful givers like you over the past 150 years have allowed this church to continue to build Christ's kingdom here on earth and change many lives. So thank you for giving. All of our giving options are up on the screen, and you can give online anytime at hollychurch.org. Now, the worship team is going to celebrate us out, and I'm looking forward to next week as we begin our new message series, Why? Invite a friend and have a celebratory week.
Everything I'd done wrong. I'm the one that dug this grave. But you call my name. You call my name. Thought that I was too far gone. For everything I'd done wrong. I'm the one that dug this grave. But you call my name. You call my name. I came alive. This beating heart, these open eyes, the grave let go, the darkness should have known. You're still rolling stones. You're still.